The simplest and therefore lowest cost Soundweb London devices are the BLU-BIB, the BLU-BOB 1, and the BLU-BOB 2. These are simple BLU-Link I/O expanders, and they're useful if you need to add analog inputs or outputs to your system at ultra-low cost. The BLU-BOB 1 and BLU-BOB 2 have identical functionality. The only difference is their size. The BLU-BOB 1 is half rack, the BLU-BOB 2 is full rack. For that reason, from here forward, I'm just going to refer to either device as BLU-BOB. The BLU-BIB and BLU-BOB are identical in their two key factors, DSP and networked audio. They both have no DSP, and they both use BLU-Link for networked audio. The only difference between the two is that the BLU-BIB has 8 analog mic line inputs, whereas the BLU-BOB has 8 analog line level outputs. Both are functionally similar to the BLU-120, another BLU-Link I/O expander, but they cost significantly less than the BLU-120 because they don't have card slots for custom I/O, an LCD screen, conditional logic processing, an Ethernet port, an RS-232 serial port, or GPIO ports. Since there are no Ethernet or serial ports, and since BLU-Link ports, of course, are audio only, this implies that the BLU-BIB and BLU-BOB are completely non-communicative devices. You cannot program them with a computer, and you cannot directly control or monitor them using any controller. If those things are critical for your installation, you should use the BLU-120 instead. BLU-BIBs and BLU-BOBs are set up using physical DIP switches and buttons located directly on the device. Let's go through an example. Let's say I have a system whose sources consist of 6 mics and 3 iPods. The destinations consist of 2 sets of simple analog powered speakers. So I need a 12x4 Soundweb London system. A system containing a BLU-50 and a BLU-BIB fits that requirement like a glove. The powered speakers would obviously be connected to the 4 analog outputs on the BLU-50. And let's say mics A, B, C, and D are connected directly to the 4 analog inputs on the BLU-50, meaning the other 2 mics and the 3 iPods would need to be connected to the BLU-BIB. The BLU-BIB's front panel buttons allow you to adjust the mic preamp gain and phantom power settings of each channel individually. These buttons allow you to select a channel for editing. These buttons allow you to adjust the preamp gain setting for the selected channel. These numbers light up to indicate the current gain setting of the selected channel. This button allows you to apply 48 volts of phantom power to the selected channel. These orange LEDs indicate which channels have phantom power turned on, and these LEDs turn green or red to indicate signal presence or clipping, respectively. Please note that there is a way to password protect these front panel buttons, basically by pressing and holding certain things. It's all detailed in the BLU-BIB installation guide. Once you've set up the front panel buttons, you just need to use the DIP switches for BLU-Link channel assignment. The BLU-BIB DIP switches assign audio onto BLU-Link in predefined blocks of 8 consecutive channels. For example, when all DIP switches are in the up position, this input gets assigned to BLU-Link channel 1, and this input goes to BLU-Link channel 2, and this goes to BLU-Link channel 3, etc. But if you move the very last DIP switch down, then this input will now go to BLU-Link channel 9, and this goes to BLU-Link channel 10, this one goes to 11, this one goes to 12, etc. For your convenience, we've printed this helpful diagram on the top of the BLU-BIB chassis. So in this case, I just need to choose a block containing channels lower than 49, since I'm sending these 8 channels to a BLU-50, which has the 48-channel BLU-Link restriction. Let's arbitrarily choose this block, channels 33 through 40. So I just need to set up the physical DIP switches as shown in the diagram, and I'm finished with the BLU-BIB. It's now taking 8 channels of analog audio, applying preamp and phantom power to some of them, converting them to digital, and inputting them onto BLU-Link channels 33 through 40. At this point, to make my system functional, I would just need to make sure the BLU-50 is receiving channels 33 through 40, which of course requires the use of a Windows-based PC running our software. Once I've done that, the BLU-BIB audio will be present within the BLU-50, where it can be processed alongside everything else. The BLU-BOB works the same as the BLU-BIB, except you're dealing with line-level outputs, so there are no front panel controls for phantom power or preamp gain, and therefore it costs even a little bit less. However, there is still a simple but useful signal presence LED per channel. This verifies that audio is exiting the analog output. So if the previous system had, for example, 12 powered speakers instead of 4, I could supplement that system with a BLU-BOB. I would just need to add the additional programming within the BLU-50. Assign the audio sends onto any 8-channel block other than channels 33 through 40. And then set up the physical dip switches on the BLU-BOB to receive that block. Let's go through another system example. You need to build a teleconferencing system whose sources consist of 8 mics, which need to communicate with remote callers over an analog phone line. You also have 4 stereo auxiliary input wall plates for people to be able to connect things like iPods or laptop audio, and 1 Bluetooth to analog receiver so people can wirelessly stream audio from their Bluetooth devices into the system. That means 18 analog inputs are needed, as well as a telephone hybrid. The system's destinations consist of 2 powered speakers, 1 set of low impedance stereo headphones, and a recording device which has 4 analog inputs. That means 8 analog outputs are needed. So you need to build an 18x8 Soundweb London system with 1 telephone hybrid and with the ability to AEC process 8 of the 18 inputs. There are multiple ways to achieve this, but the lowest cost route would be using a BLU-102 and a BLU-BIB. The BLU-102 gives you 10 of the 18 analog inputs, all 8 of the analog outputs, the 1 telephone interface, all the DSP you'll need, and 8 channels of AEC processing for the 8 mics. And the BLU-BIB gives you the 8 other inputs. There you have it. There's your low-cost 18x8 conferencing system with a telephone connection and AEC. And remember, the BLU-102 has floating AEC, which means any of the 18 inputs can be AEC processed, so it really doesn't matter where you physically connect the 8 mics. If you wanted to, you could connect them to the BLU-BIB, transmit their signal via BLU-Link into the BLU-102, and AEC process the mics there. One last note. If you wanted to, you can simply connect a BLU-BIB directly to a BLU-BOB, give both devices identical dip switch settings, and you've got yourself an 8-channel digital audio snake, no computer needed. Or you could even connect 30 BLU-BIBs to 30 BLU-BOBs, and you've got yourself a digital audio snake carrying well over 200 channels of audio on a single Cat5e cable. In systems such as this one, where multiple BLU-BIBs are being used, it's important that each BLU-BIB has a unique dip switch setting, otherwise they will conflict with each other. However, the same is not true of the BLU-BOB. So let's say you have 8 mics, and you need to split each mic 3 ways. Get 1 BLU-BIB, 3 BLU-BOBs, set up all 4 devices with identical dip switch settings, and you now have a 3-way splitter for 8 mics.